Good morning, everybody. Here René from Spain with a new video. And I was listening to this third album by Extreme, but I put it off because I don't want YouTube to take it off the channel. You know, this video. Because I was reading, I always like to read my old magazines. This one, for example, is from 1992. And then I was reading about the third album by Extreme. That's why I thought I'm gonna take it out of my collection and play it. But this video is not about that. This video I want to show some new records that I bought, you know, in the last month or something like that. I'm gonna start with one that has a lot of different opinions. I'm talking about the new Enforcer, Zenith. You see, this is the new album. For I think for 4 years they didn't record anything. But in 2015 they did a live album that also had an EP. And that EP, they already started to sound different, more melodic. But they went through with that sound. And this is more hard and heavy. You know, the speed metal is like still, like in Thunder and Hell, in the song Thunder and Hell, you still hear some of the older Enforcer. Sorry, I'm a little cold now, my voice is a little bit like this, but it's never perfect, I know, but today it's a little worse. But anyway, Thunder and Hell, like I said, has more, you know, it sounds more like the older, Enforcer. But you got songs like Regrets, Sail On. I mean, they're not strong songs. No, Die for the Devil, that was like a single. That's not a bad song, of course, but no, I'm quite disappointed with this album. You know, I'm still happy to have it in my collection because, you know, I like Enforcer a lot. And I will always buy what they release because I also buy the things I don't like so much. It's not a bad album, of course, but it's just not a good one either. It's difficult to explain, you know, I'm not so good in explaining things. The sticker said, Zenith is a brilliant collection of 10 excellent hard and heavy anthems in the vein of early Def Leppard, Scorpions, Rainbow, Judas Priest and Pretty Maids. Not one moment during this album they reach the quality of the bands I just mentioned, you know, and that is something to worry about, you know. Same as with Cauldron. Together with Skullfist and Enforcer, their new albums are disappointing me quite a lot. There's not much power on this one, it's very, very melodic, but that's not so bad after all, but it's the songwriting. You know, Prisoners of the Past is a good song, and you got a couple of other good songs on it, but again, it's not a killer album. And all these bands, they released great debut album, latest great second album, third album, fourth, some of them fourth album, but then there's a time that the quality just goes down, and I think it's a lack of dedication to the cause after a while. It already happened a lot with bands during the 70s or 80s or 90s or 2000s. You know, it's not only happening now to this new wave of traditional heavy metal bands. It's something that it's just part of the human being, you know. You first start fighting for it, and later when you reach a level and you think maybe you cannot get higher than that, or you try to get higher than that, then you fall down. You know, it happened with a lot of bigger bands too. But anyway, I hope that the next albums by these bands, like Skullfist, Cauldron and Enforcer, get better again. You know, I have hope, of course. Okay. Another album I want to show is The Brothers of Metal. This is the first full-length album by this band. This was released in 2018, but I think Digital already came out in 2017. And this is on the AFM Records, the German label. And this is an album I like very much. If you mix Lordi with Manowar, Wizard, and a touch of Majesty and Sabaton. But of course, I'm not a big Sabaton fan, but of course they are saying they sound very much like Sabaton, and they played on the Sabaton Fest also. I mean, they are from Sweden, same as Sabaton, of course. But I'm saying, if you mix those styles, then you get the mix, the style of this album. You know, it's eight people are in this band. Here they are. I don't know if you can see it right. One is of them is a girl, and it's nice the combination between the male vocalist. It sounds very much like Lordi vocalist, or and the girl vocals, because she's a very nice voice. Some very strong songs on here, like Defenders of Valhalla, Fire, Blood and Steel, and my favorite song is one I cannot spell. It's not possible to say this. I don't know in what language it is, but I never saw this word. It's Yggdrasil or something like that. Great. Okay. Then I also bought some vinyl. Let me check out. Yeah, here. Okay, I bought this one because I already had The Little Sister on CD from 2017. It came out in Europe. I think in America this CD came out a year later. But this year the vinyl version came out. I'm not going to open it. I don't think I will listen to this anyway. But I already saw it on the internet. It looks really nice. It's a gatefold. And I love the cover too. Because, you know, for once you don't see the old lineup on it. But the songs are from all the eras of Kiss. And this is the German version of the vinyl. You see, Kiss, the SS is just like that. You know, like the not like the Lightning SS. I also have the CD. Like I already bought that in 2017. I don't know if I showed the new Amon Amarth. This is a DVD. Two DVDs and a CD. And it has a nice documentary of the band. You know, that shows the 25 years of Amon Amarth. I also got this Bon Jovi album. Have a Nice Day. This one is from 2005, I think it is, but it's a re-release from 2016. I also have this on tape, of course. I bought this on tape. I don't know if I show you right now. Because a lot of people don't know that this also came out on tape. It's here. See, but only in some markets it came out on tape. I think this one is from Ukraine or from Indonesia, but it's an official release. But in the rest of the world, it didn't come out on tape anymore. Just on vinyl and on CD. And I also bought this one. I'm not sure if I showed this one before. So I bought this some time ago on Amazon. And this, it came also with a digital download. So I got the digital downloads done on my computer already. So I don't have to open this. You see, because I got it from Amazon, the digital downloads. But in the future, for sure, I will play this. I'm really waiting for the new Whitesnake album. The Flesh and Blood. I'm really waiting for that album to be released. Because the stuff I hear is amazing. I bought some more Bon Jovi. And this is The Circle by Bon Jovi. And this was never released on tape. You know, this one, no. But for example, These Days, of course, yes. And Bounce was still released also on tape. But this thing didn't come out, not even in other countries anymore. You know, this one, no. But once I will show my tape collection, my Bon Jovi tape collection. I have all the tapes. See? Good. I also bought this one in El Corte Inglés. It's a shop in Spain. And this is the best of both worlds. You know, like in 2003, 2004, Sammy Hagar came back in the band. He was for a while in the band again. They made three new songs. They put them on here. Three new songs. And the rest is just the best of both worlds. You know. David Lee Roth. And Sammy Hagar. They completely forget about the singer of Extreme. It was also on one record. Of Van Halen. I bought this re-release. Of Renewal. By Creator. This came out originally in 92. And this is the re-release. But this is not the Digibook version. You know, I have a lot of the re-releases on Digibook, but this is just on carton, you know, like very soft. Not very soft, but softer. Softer than the Digibook one. You see, but also has some bonus tracks. I mean, this album, I never liked it. I mean, I have this on tape, I bought it, you know, I recorded it when it came out. A friend bought it, and he recorded for me on tape. But I never bought it, and now I saw it for €8.50, and I bought it. And I like it now a lot more, or I like it more now than before. It's still not a killer album, but I like it more. Okay, I think this is everything I want to show. I don't know if I showed this one by Ted Nugent already. Nice. Two CD sets, Double Life Gonzo. Classic Life, of course. I didn't play it yet, but I also I bought this in Fnac. Maybe I already showed this, I don't know. Okay, everybody, have a nice day and stay metal, everybody. Take care.